always struggle for topics to speak about. I have lots of ideas. I always have advice. If anybody wants advice, talk to me. But when it comes time to give a talk, I have a hard time thinking of what to tell you. Well, that's not very important. You know, maybe it's just trivial. I know Mark likes for a story to have a purpose. What is your purpose? I want to know. So the burden got even greater with the idea of purpose. But I am very fond of this group. And I think I will give advice for 2016. By show of hands, how many of you have New Year's resolution? Okay. All right. Why do we do New Year's resolutions? What is it about this time of year that makes us think, I'm going to conquer the world? Because we have, all of us in this room have perfect attendance in Toastmasters today. We haven't missed a meeting yet this year, right? My son went back to school today. I said, you know what? Aim for 90% or 100 on everything you do now that you're back at school today. So you know what? No. Aim for 100%. There's no point in aiming for 90, right? So when you get home, start your homework, and you want to just do the very best job that you can do. And right now, he has no flaws in that record, right? So there's something very alluring to the new year, a fresh start. We've got 365-ish days to make something happen. 366, we got a bonus day this year. So we're off to a roaring start. And a lot of times what people say is, you know, maybe a couple of real avid business people in this room, I'm going to top last year's performance. A lot of us go, I'm going to lose weight, or I'm going to exercise more. And those are good things to do, but maybe they're not as specific as they ought to be. But I think for me, although, yeah, I could afford to lose some weight, that'd be awesome. I could afford to be more fit, but I think I'm going to change my focus a little. My goal is to prevent some aging. So I want to pass on some of these ideas to you as well, because I, like I said, I am fond of the people in this room, and I want to give you some thoughts to think about. So as we age, some things happen, and you know, we can look at people and kind of guess how old they are based on not just their physical appearance, but also their manner, right? They're a little stiffer, their posture's a little bit poorer usually, especially, I mean, I don't know about you all, I'm driving down the road and I see somebody kind of standing like this. I'm like, you know, stand up straight. People slow down, not just physically, but mentally. There can be a loss of balance. A lot of times older people fall because their balance is compromised. Loss of strength, higher blood pressure. There's a lot of things that we sometimes just say, well, that's part of aging. And we can just say, well, that's part of aging. I mean, acceptance is good, right? Being okay with yourself. But we can also do some things to help mitigate a little for that. So I was going to talk to you today about physical, mental, and emotional health. And these aren't new ideas, but they might be something you haven't thought about in a little while. Physically, obviously we need to eat better, right? I mean, not everybody in this room. A lot of people are like crazy fit in this room. I'm not saying that you don't already do these things. But what we need to do is give all of our cells the best shot, right? If we eat nutritious food, nutrition-packed food, things rich in antioxidants, our cells regenerate and stay healthier. We need to move more, some of us. And sure, I can exercise harder, and I should. But I mean, I sit at a desk hours and hours at a time. And like, yay me, I have stamina for sitting at a desk. Right? But I don't know that that's going to help me when I'm 60 or 70. I think what I need to do is get reminders that get up and move. Just move a little bit. Try to get in, I think the goal, popular goal is 10,000 steps. We were at Disneyland for 3 days, and we got those steps like twice over every day. That's the most walking and standing I've done in a long time. But it made me think, I need to do this more. Getting enough sleep, that's when cells regenerate, right? So 7 to 8 hours of sleep. Sometimes we think we can burn the candle at both ends, get up early, stay up late, do a whole lot of stuff. Right, we've expanded our day. But my I do it. I don't know if we're effective. Everybody say effective.
Effective.
I cannot hear that word. Seriously, though, if you've ever sat and done some puzzles or anything like that, at the end of an evening, do that sometime. Just sit there and try to figure out a puzzle and come back to it the next day when you're rested and, oh my God, it's so much easier. Right? But life is like that. Sometimes staying up late is not paying off. Get up in the morning and do things when you're fresh. Drink more water. Cells need water. Your whole body is composed of water. Stand up straight, right? Your spinal alignment is important to regeneration and staying young, looking young for crying out loud, right? And then just breathe. Deep breathing. A lot of times we breathe shallow. We're sitting at our desks. We're not getting full oxygenation to our brains for our thinking or to our cells for regeneration. So, mentally, keep your brain alive. This is actually a CD, an audiobook, for suggesting. We know that brains develop in the early years in children with lots of synapses, lots of connections. Things can, they're learning constantly. But when they reach their teen years, you start pruning. The brain starts getting rid of connections that aren't used very often, and it strengthens the ones that you use all the time. Ergo, spending a lot of time on video games and things like that, you're missing out on some opportunities for strengthening better synapses. But by playing games, I already held up some of the game books and things. Play puzzles. Do games that make you think. That keeps your brain alive. Change things up. Try brushing your teeth with your left hand, right? Because you're not going to probably hurt yourself. I mean, cutting something sharp with your left hand might not be the best thing, but change things. Stand for a few minutes while you're flossing your teeth on one foot or the other foot, right? I mean, like, work on things that just, it's incidental. It doesn't take additional time. But especially, I'd encourage you to learn new things. Is there something you loved doing as a kid or as a young adult and you haven't touched in a while? Or I've always wanted to do this, I'm going to take a class. Learning new things helps keep your brain sharp as well. Finally, emotionally, live simply. We don't have to do 500 things in a day. We think we do, but we don't. Triage. If you had to just pick the top three, what would they be? Let's do those, right? Unplug. Don't spend all your time looking at your phone. You're losing time in your life. Meditate. It's like training a puppy to sit. Sometimes our brains wander, right? And maybe we need to be present. So meditation is a way to learn that. Fully use the time that you have. Decide consciously that you're not going to give up hours on the phone if that's not important to what you do. You know. Finally, be thankful. Express appreciation to people. Make it a goal to talk to somebody once a day, somebody else. One person a day and just express appreciation. You'll feel really good. And wear sunscreen because we can prevent some wrinkles, but the ones that you can't, be kind, smile. They may as well be smile lines. Mr. Toastmaster.